Yeah, so, hello, good morning. It's Monday, February 1st. Sun was shining. Seems like it just went behind a cloud. I thought this was a good place to start. I thought I wanted to do like a video blog thing. But I don't know how long or how hard it will be to post something that's a little bit longer than 30 seconds, so we'll see. Anyway, I thought this was a good place to start because I'm going uphill. And I'm going uphill, maybe going slow. Holy cow. Part of some windmill, I'm sure. Anyway, going slow means the wind isn't too bad, so hopefully you can hear me okay. It also means my heart rate's now up to 120 and I need to breathe as well as talk. But I suppose I should be grateful I can still do both of those. Anyway, almost up to the top of the hill. It's about a 6% grade hill. Not a big deal. Just a whole lot of those are Mont Tremblant Ironman. Steeper than that. Anyway, okay. So the top of the hill, what I want to talk about. A couple of related things, I guess. I originally thought, I gotta turn my music off. Too distracting here. Originally thought I'd talk about the old Serenity Prayer. You know that one. I don't know who put those words together, but probably more than one person, that's usually the way it is. Anyway, God grant me the serenity to accept the things I cannot change, the courage to change the things I can, and the wisdom to know the difference. You know, the first one's hard enough. There's things in your life that really hurt. You can't change them. It's hard to be serious about it. The second one, courage to change the things I can. Yeah, courage. Everybody's courage is different, right? What may seem very courageous for one person is not for another person. So we all have our own measure of that. Anyway, I know there's things I can change and I don't have the guts to do it. Hopefully sometime. And of course the wisdom to know the difference is the biggest one of all, because you haven't figured out whether you can or cannot change something. And you could be beating your head along against the wall a long time. Anyway, wisdom's supposed to come with age. I'm not sure if it is for me. Certainly it's the other part of the equation for me is age, turning 60. Need to make change. Believing I need to make change, and you know, I guess one thing you may ask, why do you think you need to make change? Well, make change, we're not satisfied. But I'm not satisfied. I think I'll make a distinction between happy and satisfied. With happy is a relative thing. And it's fleeting and it comes and goes. And satisfaction, I think, should somehow transcend happiness. It's somehow, I don't know, a peaceful kind of thing. Yeah. I remember saying that after my first Ironman, I was happy, but not satisfied. So, I think I need to work on satisfied. And by my calculations, I'm 60 years old. I think 80, based on my genetics, my lifestyle, all those things, I think 80 is a pretty good number. I'll be very surprised if I last longer than that anyway. Certainly I don't anticipate being useful beyond 80. Anyway, I can still do basic math even at 60, and I know that 60 is 3/4 of the way to 80. That means I got 1/4 of my life left, 20 years to do something with. I think I once heard the expression that the purpose of life is a life of purpose. And I think that makes sense. You gotta have a purpose, and you gotta have a direction. I don't know if those are the same thing or not, but I'm not sure they're connected. So what's my purpose? What's my direction? Who the fuck knows? Therein, I suspect, lies the problem. You know, all my life there's been one strong purpose after another. Whether it be helping Rue raise our kids, whether it be my job, of course there was lots of purpose there, lots of direction. Always something to do, always something to occupy your mind, always something to satisfy your ego. And then probably in the later years, you know, I don't know, pretty pathetic maybe, but Iron Man became my purpose. It became my true north. All the exercise and the buying the toys and the camaraderie and the pride. It all felt purposeful. It all felt useful. And especially, I think, in my case, because I tried to do something more with it than just the athletic part of it. I tried to use it as a metaphor for life. I tried to, you know, bring value out of it to the world in general, but especially to those that love me, that I love. But now, I say I'm not satisfied because I don't have work. My kids are growing up, I still meddle in their lives, but the truth be known, I ain't having much influence, and that's as it should be. And I could do myself a big favor by staying out of it. Where it was really found a comfort zone. She loves spending time with her grandchildren. She loves her job. She likes making lasagna for me. We call it Mary's lasagna. It's a Sister Mary's recipe. Anyway, I digress. Where the hell was I? Yeah, about purpose, right? What's my purpose? What's my direction? Oh, this freaking video's working. If not, I suppose I have to hope that talking to myself will be valuable exercise today. Maybe as I talk, I should think about just making it a valuable exercise for myself. And if it happens that it does record and I can publish it, then beautiful. Anyway, I don't know what to do right now. I'm just kind of lost. You know, one day I wake up and say, screw all this. You know, it's all in my head. You know, get out there and get your body training, use your brain. You know, of course you're older, so you're gonna go slower. But it's all in your mind, Peter. It's all just a big freaking mental block. You've been to the doctor enough. He told you right, nothing wrong with you. So get on with it. So then I take that and I go out and I go walk down the driveway and I did it again yesterday. I said, okay, I feel fine. I'm just gonna jog really, really slowly and until I get into a rhythm. And then I thought, okay, I'm starting to get lightheaded real quickly, just after 5 or 6 seconds, but I'm just gonna keep going. And it'll dissipate and I'll find a rhythm. So took another 4 or 5 steps. And hopefully proved that I wasn't totally stupid, because I was 90% sure that if I took 3 or 4 more, I would black out completely. And if I blacked out completely, I'm probably gonna fall on my face. And while that in itself, wouldn't that be big a tragedy? But what if, you know, I don't know. Or if I seriously hurt myself, or... So anyway, reined it back, walked. Had a frustrating 7 kilometers around the block. Mostly walk. Heart rate won't go up. I get, short of breath. Anxious. Legs tighten up. Yeah, it's ridiculous. I think it's ridiculous. Either there's something physiological wrong that we simply haven't discovered, I need to keep looking, or it's all in my freaking head, and maybe it is. So, one thing I've decided to do, and this may or may not surprise you if you know me, is I decided to go see the head shrinker. Talked to my doctor about this, or Claudette and I did, and all three of us acknowledge that maybe there'd be some added value. I know and believe that the body and mind are interconnected in ways beyond our current knowledge, and I believe it's possible that stress, anxiety, depression, all those things are so powerful that they can affect you physically to a great extent. Whether that's the case with me or not, I don't know. Whether I'll be interesting enough to this doctor for him to help me explore it, I don't know. I know that that's been my experience, right? With doctors in general, as they want to have fun too. And if you're just another boring person who there's nothing really obvious wrong with, they got more important shit to do. What they see is more important anyway. Things that they see as life-threatening or whatever. So I don't know if you can see this. Here comes another one of these trucks, these wide loads, and they go up and down our road by the hundreds, because just to the east of us they build windmills. And so you see these huge huge pipes, I guess, which are the vertical part of the windmill, the going down the road one way and down the other way. For whatever reason, always seems to see the windmill blades and these huge trucks. Anyway, wind energy is a topic for another day. Gotta get back to my the reason for my mouth starting to get a bit cold. My thoughts are getting a bit scrambled. Sorry. It's all about the Serenity Prayer. the wisdom to know the difference between the things that cannot change, can and cannot change, and having a purpose. So I don't know. I don't have any effing answers today. I tell you, I'm not discouraged, but I am discouraged. There's another element to my whatever recent experiences is my dreaming, my dreams. I can't even tell you. I had a dream on Friday night that I don't think I'll ever forget. It was beyond, it was the most beyond my imagination as far as horrid dreams. And I don't know, it's gotta be connected somehow. Because no matter how I go to bed feeling, of enthusiasm perhaps, or at least okay, I wake up after a night of dreams like that and I just want to die. I'm telling you, I just want to die. You know, I'll be totally frank with you, I was away with Colby all weekend. I had such wonderful times, and if it wasn't for the time spent with him and enjoying watching him play hockey and enjoying our interaction, enjoying our little arguments, enjoying our little debates, enjoying, you know, getting to know him better, letting him know me better. If it wasn't for all that, I don't know. I would have jumped off a freaking cliff on Saturday morning. I think the dream was so bad. I don't know. I tried to describe it to Rue without describing the dream, because I don't want to describe the dream. But I couldn't even find the words. Anyway, I don't know, psychiatrist talk about those things. I don't know if they know anything about those things, but I'm gonna ask him, her, it, which makes me laugh, him, her, it, because you have to fill out this questionnaire before you go to the psychiatrist and bring it with you. One of the questions is, how would you like to be known? He, she, it, or they? kind of made me laugh. My temptation, of course, would be provocative and use one of the unusual ones, or even make up one of my own, but I ended up just putting he. But they. Yeah, that's interesting. Anyway, again, I'm off on a freaking tangent somewhere. There's no possible way I'll be able to post all this to my blog, certainly not with our internet connection, but I don't know. Again, like I say, I can watch the whole thing myself and see if there's value in it for me, so. Anyway, so that's the immediate plan. When I say immediate, I already decided this about 6 or 8 weeks ago, to so go see the psychiatrist. But it takes a while, of course. So we'll see. That's week after next. Am I embarrassed in any way to tell you? I don't think so. You know, it is what it is, and I'm just searching for answers, and I'll go to any place that I think I can find the answers. Or let me qualify that. I'll go to any place within reason. There's some things that, some places where I just can't go because it just didn't work for me. You know, one of them is religion. Now let me make a distinction. When I say religion, not spirituality. Spirituality I'm good with, in the talking to God and asking for help and looking for peace and accepting that there's a power far greater than me. that may or may not be paying attention to me specifically, but certainly that in the end it ain't gonna make no big freaking difference. I've always been a big fan of the expression, let go and let God. God is whatever you perceive him to be, as the alcoholics say. But religion is a different matter for me. You know, go talk to a priest or a minister would be abhorrent to me. And frankly, because religion as it functions in our world is part of the problem in my mind. But I still think that there's probably possibilities for me there. Anyway, again, I'm going off. It's going to get tiresome to listen to, but I'll stick with the point. The point is, I'm 60 years old. I need to find greater purpose. I need to find greater direction. That's the reason I need to make change. And if I don't do it now, when am I going to do it? When I'm 64, as whoever the hell that is, Paul, which has name, Paul McCartney guy, says, will you still need me? Will you still feed me when I'm 64? 64. Anyway, maybe 64 I'll do another Ironman. I think I better leave it at that. I know this is probably one big jumbled mess, but it is what it is. Should have looked up a quote for you and memorized it before I sign off, but I don't know, maybe I'll think of something. If I add something at the end of the video, when I do think of something, I'll pop it in there and then see if I can add it in. Alright. God bless the whole world. No exceptions. Love, Peter.